In this experiment, we are going to use electricity to separate copper and chloride ions. Okay, it's an electrolysis experiment, so we're separating using electricity. This is the power supply that we're going to use. I've got it set at 12 volts, and we're going to use the DC power supply, direct current, so that one electrode is continually positive, one electrode is continually negative, and that allows us to separate the two ions. Okay, so I'm going to put one wire into the red socket of the DC supply, another wire into the black socket of the DC supply, and I have got my electrode holder, which is going to sit on top of the beaker here. And I've got my carbon electrodes here that I'm going to just hold in place with the crocodile clips. And then I can attach the wires to the crocodile clips. Okay, so the black wire is attached to the negative terminal of the power supply, and the red wire is attached to the positive terminal of the power supply. So this is my positive electrode, and this is my negative electrode. I can then add my copper chloride solution to the beaker. You can see copper chloride solution is a blue coloured solution because of the blue coloured copper ions that are in there. Okay. So we have got the power supply set to 12 volts. I'm now going to turn on the power supply, and we're looking to observe any changes that happen at each electrode. So you can see straight away here at the positive electrode, we have a gas formed. You can see the bubbles of gas forming there at the positive electrode. And at the negative electrode, you can see that a solid is starting to form on that electrode there, on the negative electrode. Okay, so we can confirm that it's chlorine gas being produced at the positive electrode using some moist blue litmus paper. Chlorine gas will bleach moist blue litmus paper. So if I hold that just above the electrode, you can see already that that blue moist litmus paper has bleached, confirming that it's chlorine gas that's formed. And you can also, just by gently wafting, you'll get the characteristic chlorine smell as well. So at the negative electrode, we have got this solid formed, and the solid formed is copper. The copper ions from solution, the positive copper ions have been attracted to the negative electrode, where they've gained electrons to form copper atoms, so copper has been formed.